Corey here, getting ready to start an actual clean and repair and then clean actually. I've got a doorway basically, which is, it's just the most famous repair that I do. The typical doorway repair, plus I've got an area where I think it was a cat that did it. He did something naughty to the carpet. I don't really know what it is, but it'll clean out just fine. I'm gonna cover basically the repair and then the cleaning of the carpet and clean right over the repair. And then that gives you generally the best outcome when you clean over the repair, and it makes it blend a whole lot better. Let me show you where I'm starting. All right, right here's the damage. And then right here, and right here is, I'll be cleaning this room to get these two areas here. So I've already taken what I needed. That's how this is gonna work. I took this piece out of the closet. This piece is going to go at the edge of the doorway right there. I'm gonna put that in there. And then I've got this piece here. This is going to go back in the closet. This is what I brought with me. So when you put that in the closet and put your shoes on it, you don't have a problem anymore. You got the problem solved here. All right, I'm going to probably set it up in time lapse and start cutting into this guy here. And you'll see me cut into it, take it out, put a piece of carpet tape down underneath it, and then start seaming it together. So at certain points, I'll probably stop and catch you up what I'm doing. But for now, you're gonna see me working in high speed to get this guy opening the door, open it and closing it, and getting everything cut the way it needs to be. So I can get started out on that right now. Got this guy seamed in there now. What I'm gonna do now is go over here to the closet, and I'm gonna seam this guy in. And then I'm not gonna cover any of this. And when I get done seaming this guy in, I'm gonna finish out the door, and I'm gonna watch that. And we'll also watch me tucking in. I don't believe there's a Z bar here, which is good. Let's see. Oh hell, there is a Z bar. Okay. Sorry about that. I was gonna talk about the Z bar again if it wasn't there. Anyway, a guy asked me yesterday about Z bar, where Z bar belongs. Z bar belongs on a carpet to linoleum, something like that, or carpet to VCT tile or something like that, where a carpet is going to a lower surface. That way the carpet just wraps around and it'll be a little bit higher than the surface it's going to. When you take carpet to wood, you just you tuck it between the little area right between the tack strip and the wood itself. Anyway, I'm going to fix this guy over here, and then we'll be back to finish out this guy. All right, guys, we're going to finish it out on this side first. And then we're going to turn it around. Finish out the other side. This side, you just basically, you're tucking in and you're cutting it off. So, not a lot of heavy instructions here. Make sure you got a sharp razor. At this point, it's fairly warm in here because I've steamed together two fairly large repairs, so the temperature has changed in here. It is quite humid. right now. We'll see if we can do that. I doubt there's anybody's gonna be able to see that. I'll leave it right there like that, maybe. Now, the difficult part, the part that I just hate.
Alright, we got us a little bit of background music there.
Alright. I'm gonna roll this Z-bar back. It's usually pretty tricky to get it rolled back. You want to roll it back without damaging it. So, several different tools you can use to get it lift. You can only bend it so many times. It's just aluminum. Heating it today. Yesterday I did a heat and tuck. Not today, we won't be. This guy needs to be cut off a little bit, and then I'll be able to tuck it in. So I've got it looks fairly even, so I should be able to cut back just a couple of rows at a time and finally get it right where I want it. I usually cut it several times before I get it right. I'm gonna go two rows back right now. That might, believe it is, that's going to be enough. I use the, chisel this direction so as not to hit the wood floor. Here. Thank you. All right, guys, we are done making this repair here. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna come back, I'm gonna put away all my tools, and I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna clean this whole room right over this repair, and then we'll take a look at everything when I'm done. So I'll cover some of the cleaning. All right, guys, now we're back. I've brought the Challenger in. We're gonna clean this room. Basically, with emphasis right here on all of this. They wanted to patch this whole area, and you know, ethically, I could patch the whole area, but I can also clean it considerably cheaper and faster on my end. So we're gonna clean this. Then I'm gonna clean right to and over the repair and get a perfect blend on that. So I guess I'm gonna pre-spray, right? I guess I'll show the pre-spraying. Room is awfully small. All right, I'm gonna get the pre-spray. All right, I guess if you're watching here, you saw that go almost completely away when I hit it with peroxide. All right, so that makes me believe it's gonna clean out really, really well here. I'm gonna get the Challenger and we're gonna clean it. I guess we'll do it in real time. All right, I am gonna add one step to this one. I'm gonna put a dry towel down. All right, I'm gonna spin a dry towel over the whole room just to speed the drying up a little bit. There's no fan in there, so I'm gonna do that. And leave it a little drier, and then we'll be done. I'll groom it. One last step here. After 5 minutes here on that whole cleaning thing. This is the repair that I made, cleaned over. So when you clean over it, you get damn near perfect. I mean, just perfect. Nobody would ever walk in here and think there was ever an issue there, or they would never know that cat shat all over the room. You never know that. All right, that is truly effective cleaning and repair. All right, guys, that does it. And actually, that was not expensive at all. That was very, very friendly on the price for me to do what I just did. So if you have questions or want to buy a challenger to start your own business, shoot me a text, 512-350-1129. I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching, guys, and God bless.